गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो हियर आई एम स्टार्टिंग हियर चैप्टर फोर पाइथन फंडामेंटल्स। द मेन टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर्स आर पाइथन कैरेक्टर सेट, टोकन्स, वेयर बोन्स ऑफ अ पाइथन प्रोग्राम, वेरिएबल्स एंड सिंपल इनपुट एंड आउटपुट स्टेटमेंट विच वी हैव ऑल्सो कवर्ड इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर। So the first topic is a character set. So every language has a different character set. This character set may be a ASCII or ISCII and a Unicode character set. So Python support the Unicode character set. In Unicode characters, this language will take 2 bytes of memory for a single character. So we can say okay, what do you understand by a character set? So a character set is a set of valid characters which a language can recognize. These characters may be a letters, digits, special symbols and others characters. Now the next most important topic is a token. So token is a smallest part of a Python program. Tokens may be a keyword, identifier, literal, operator and punctuator. So Python has the following tokens, and in every languages these are the 5 tokens, that is keyword, identifier, literals, operators and punctuators. You can understand this with the help of a program. So here name and age, these are the variable, and the value of that is a Anya and 15. So the values is called a literal and a variable is called identifier. And print is a reserve word which is used for printing. So this is called a keyword. And brackets, commas, inverted commas, all these are called a punctuator or a separator. Now what are the definition of the keywords? So keywords are the reserve words in a programming language which is reserved for a special purpose. So we can't use these variable as an identifier. And just see, this is the list of keywords which is used in Python: false, assert, del, for, in, is, from, elif, break. So alls are, these are the keywords. So we cannot take the name of any variable, just like a break, del or for, because these are the reserved for different purposes. So first two definition is interconnected to each other. Number first is the keyword and second is identifier. So what do you mean by the identifier? Identifier are the fundamental building blocks of a programs, and these are the name of a variables or a functions or a array, etc. So we can say identifier are the name of any part of a program. So there are the some rules for identifier. The names of identifiers should be begins with alphabet. So we can say age is a correct identifier. Age 1 is also a correct identifier, but 1 age is not a valid, because identifier cannot start from digit. We can take a uppercase and lowercase identifier that will be a valid. Next rule is space is not allowed in identifier. We can use the underscore sign in identifier, but special symbols are not allowed in identifier. Uppercase and lowercase name will be different as an identifier. So you can understand this. So these are the valid identifier, my file. So this Y file and this second capital Y file both will be different because this is the case sensitive language. And now these are the some invalid in this. Dash is not allowed. Here the system will understand that REC record is minus from our data. This is also a invalid because this is start from numbers. Third one is break, so this is a keyword, and fourth one is dot inside a name, so special symbols are not allowed. Third category are the literals. Literals are also referred as constants, so these are not changed during the execution of a program. Literals may be a string literal, numeric literal, boolean literal, a special literal, and a literal collection. So number first literal here is a string literal. So the text which is enclosed in a single quotes, double quotes, or triple quotes is called a string literal in Python. These can contain a one character or more character. So these all are the valid examples of string literal. Astha, Rizwan, Hello World, Armies. Or if we are writing a numbers inside a single quotes or double quotes, so this will also treated in Python as a string literal. Now the next topic is a escape sequence characters. So escape sequence characters are the characters. These are also called the non-graphic characters. So these will not print on the screen. We will get the effect of these characters. So let's understand when we will use slash commas. So this will give a single quotes. When we will use the slash inverted comma, so this will give a double quotes. Or if we want to change the line, so there is a slash n. Or if we want a horizontal tab space, so there is a escape sequence character is a slash t. So slash t slash n slash single inverted comma and slash double inverted comma, these are the mostly will be used in Python programming language.